What's up, guys? It's Lindsay, and I am back for another video. You are getting a special treat today because in this one video, you are gonna get two Benz hauls. This video will be of the two hauls from Saturday and Sunday. I will show you all of Saturday first, and then I will show you all of Sunday. Bear with me. I know this is gonna be a long video, so sorry, because they're not normally this long when I do Benz trips. Anyway, let's go ahead and get into it, starting off with the Saturday Benz trip first. So I don't normally check the shoes because they don't normally have shoes, but this is the first thing that I got. These are kids though, so they're youth size 5. I looked them up online, and these are the Nike Low Burrow, I think is what they're considered. I don't know if I will put a picture up or not to show like how dirty these were prior to me cleaning them, because these are cleaned. They did not come out of the bins this way. The white was super, super gross and super dark, and I cleaned them up. I washed and dried the shoelaces also, just so that they would be a little bit better condition. I think in one of my previous videos, I had got a vintage pillowcase. I am going for a boho theme in my room, so anytime I come across these, I grab them just because I really like the look and they're vintage. And so this is for myself. This is a dress that I got for my mom because she has one similar from this brand that she really likes, but this is just a little vintage, fresh produce dress, and it's got a little fish on there. It says it's from 1999, and it's just like a little summer dress with pockets. So this brand is very exciting to me because I've heard of it, but I've never found it. I've never sold it either, so I don't really know what the sell-through rate is or how good it is, so we are gonna see. But I found new with tags, John Varvatos or Varvatos, I'm not really sure how you say it. Again, a brand that I've never picked up before. They're a size 56 in his sizing. That is not a size 56 waist, because I wanted to make sure of that. A size 56 equates to about an extra large. They retailed at $298, and there's that. They're not wool or anything, but they're just a basic, like, black slack with pockets on the back. This is a vintage late edition limited dress, so there's the tag. And this is just a little black velvet like mini dress. Yeah, it hits at about the knee, so it's about a mini dress. Yeah, super basic. It's got shoulder pads. The only thing is, I did not realize until I got home that the seams, and I don't even know if you're gonna see it or not, but the seams right here at the shoulder pad are actually ripped on both sides. There you go. And so it should be an easy repair, but I just thought this would be great for the holidays. This is Anne Klein, size small, which I don't normally pick up Anne Klein, but I was inclined to pick this up because it is a brown suede jacket, and obviously leather and suede always does well this time of the year. Then this was the trip of silk. I got tons of silk. So this is an older Banana Republic. I looked it up and it was about, I think the tag said 2005 or 2006, but size large, 100% silk. And this is just like a swimsuit cover up, but it's a really, really pretty, it's a really pretty color. It's got all these blues and yellows and greens in it, so that's a great travel thing. So this felt really nice. I looked at it and I was like, this has to be silk, and sure enough it was. The brand is Jim Thompson. It's just really, really gorgeous. The print is gorgeous. I just really, really like it. And then this is the third silk piece that I got. This is a vintage Tess Woman, size 3X. And this is just a little like button-up blouse with little lavender flowers. And then I found this older, I thought it was vintage. It's not quite vintage. I think it was like mid 2000s maybe. J. Jill. It does say it's a medium petite, but I honestly might just list this as medium because where the sleeves hit, someone would easily wear it as a 3/4 sleeve, but it's just this little, like, almost like corduroy, kind of like eggplant jacket. This is another winter item. So this is a Chico's one. So Chico's and their size one. And it's, again, also kind of similar color to that. It's kind of like eggplant purple, kind of, with this like silver metallic. And it's just this knit duster that hits at about the knee, just open front. I personally do not pick up Chico's unless it's vintage. And so I don't really know how, it's going to do. This is just kind of a little basic shirt. This is a vintage Eddie Bauer. No idea on the size because I think it was cut, but my guess is it's probably a large, and it's just like a high neck plain black long sleeve. So here is the tag. This is a 3/4 zip Tommy Bahama pullover. And it's just got the Tommy Bahama embroidery on the back. I love selling Tommy Bahama. It normally does pretty well for me, so I always pick it up. Another brand that always does well for me is new Polo Ralph Lauren. This label always does well and sells pretty fast. They're a size large, and these are just your basic, like, dark gray sweatpants. And they got the pony embroidered on the side there. Another brand that does well is new Abercrombie and Fitch, or newer, like within the last year or two. So this is like an open knit cardigan in burgundy, and it's got like a balloon sleeve. And yeah, this was a grab as I was leaving. So this is a vintage Blair jacket, and it is a size 2X, which is great because it's a bigger size. And this is kind of more like spring colors, but it is a jacket. You know, people are still looking for jackets this time of year. This is a 2004 Mariners spring training shirt. And then obviously I always look for school stuff no matter what it is. This is a school that is local here, Pacific Lutheran, or PLU as we call it. And this is a Champion size large. It's not vintage, but it is a 1/4 zip, and it's got tackle twill on the front. This is a vintage or Y2K Papillon. I never know how to pronounce that. Papillon, size medium, and it's this little like boho lace, like cream lace with the little like fake rhinestones on the front, just like a little, I think it might be like a tunic. It's a little too short for a dress. So it could just be a long style tank top also. These are vintage Stefano International, size 14, vintage size 14, but just your plain little faded black vintage mom jeans. I have found a lot of rails lately, surprisingly, but modern rails that is not flannels. So this is a Rails XL, and this is just like a boxy sweatshirt. This vintage, I don't know how to say it, Le Coq Sportif. I don't know how you say it. It's got a little bit of a color run around the letters there, but this is a size medium. Definitely got some flaws, but I just think this is kind of a fun polo because it's so like racing oriented, just with the checkers. This is a BCBG Max Azria, and this is just very like Y2K with like the halter, and I just thought this print was really fun and retro. This is a vintage Erica Studio. This is a like little leopard midi dress with the buttons down the front, and then it ties in the back, and it's got shoulder pads, and I just think this is so cute. Animal print also does well this time of the year. This is a vintage Necessary Objects. which I think I've seen before, but this is just like a little sheer vest, and it buttons right there. Last from this haul is this Ray Lewis jersey. It is a youth and it's a size large, so it's a 14-16. This is Reebok, and as you know, Reebok only did the NFL's jerseys up until a certain point, and I can't remember when that was. Comps looked pretty decent, even for the kids' jerseys for his name. He was a popular player, so with football season going on right now, I don't think this is going to be hard to sell. That is everything from the Saturday trip. Let's go ahead and show everything from the Sunday trip as well. Let's go ahead and show you roll right into Sunday's haul. Okay, so this was one of the last things I found as I was walking out. So this is a vintage Erica and Company Petite. It's got wool, polyester, acrylic, and nylon. It's this really cute, like, perfect for this time of the year, but it's a flannel cropped wool jacket. And then it's got like this satin interior, but oh my gosh, this is just so, I guarantee you this is probably gonna sell really quick on Depop. And here is the tag on that. So I don't know if this is handmade or if this is like, I have no idea, but this is just super, super fun. This is a vest and it's got like all these mirrors and everything all over it. And it's pretty like heavy, heavy duty. Found tons of vintage Eddie Bauer today. It was actually like kind of crazy. I never find this much Eddie Bauer, and I love selling Eddie Bauer. So this is vintage Eddie Bauer, women's size large, and it's just a green, it's not even cable knit, but it's just a green knit sweater. It does have a flaw right here on the front, but great for this time of the year. I also grabbed this as I left. I didn't look up comps, I just grabbed it because it's a flannel. And it's buffalo plaid, I think is what they call that, but this is L.L. Bean's signature, size extra large regular. I have never seen this L.L. Bean tag, so my guess is this is probably like their most current tag, meaning this is probably very new. So this is just a little flannel. This is the brand Untuck It. So I sold or had an Untuck It item listed for a very long time, and it took forever to sell. Maybe I'll have better luck with this brand under linen rather than, I think what I had was maybe just like a polo shirt. So this is a vintage Casual Corner, which is another vintage brand that I like to sell, in a size 16. And this is just a suede leather like button up. So another suede item, great for this time of the year. Another jean brand that I like to sell now, this is new Abercrombie & Fitch, and this is a high-rise mom jean, Curve Love, size 27/4. And these are very distressed with a ripped out knee, blown out knee. Backs are, you know, purposely like that. This I was gonna throw back, and then I realized that it was new with the tag. This is Coldwater Creek, again size medium, just a brown little lightweight knit like cardigan. It's got the original tag on there, which is gonna be perfect for this time of the year for Christmas. Original retail at $59.95. This I kind of saw last minute as well. I was gonna throw it back, and then I was like, no, I like the colors too much. I grabbed this and thought that it was gonna be like Forever 21 or Wild Fable or American Eagle or something, but it's not. It's actually vintage, and it's called It's Our Time. It's a size small, and it's super, super soft. You know me, I always tend to find the quirky sweaters. So this is a vintage Sag Harbor in a size extra large, and it's got all these little doodads all along the front on it. This I bought with the intention of keeping it for myself as long as it's not too small. This is also a size medium, but that's what I wear. This is from 2006, and it's just a Seahawks long sleeve, and then it says Seattle down the sleeve. Trust me, I do this all the time. And then the copyright is Now and Zen. I looked this shirt up. This shirt in a long sleeve is listed on Grailed for like over $600, and there's only a couple of them listed. The other one was listed at $17, and I can't remember if the other ones were listed high or not. I don't know if this is from a movie. I don't know if this is a quote that I should know. No idea. This is a Sleeping on Snow, size extra small, small. And Sleeping on Snow is a Anthropologie brand, which I don't pick up Anthropologie anymore, but being what this is why I grabbed it. It's a, obviously a waterfall, like a waterfall style cardigan, and it's just cream, and it's pretty good weight. 7% wool, 4% alpaca, and then the rest is cotton, acrylic, and nylon. Okay, I'm excited about these because I've never sold Lane Bryant jeans, I don't think, before. But these are a size 20. It's the Flex Magic Waistband Curvy Fit High Rise Straight. I honestly think these might just be new without the tags, because new jeans just look different after they've been washed. And it's still got the little thing there and on the inside, but here is the tag. It's obviously the newer Lane Bryant label. Found another vintage, well, not vintage, but just another suede leather jacket. This is Liz Claiborne, but this is newer, so this is probably from like mid-2000s maybe. It's a 1X, so great size. Regular Goodwill apparently was charging $8.99 for it, is what they had it marked at, and it did not sell. Basic 100% leather jacket, suede leather, so another great leather piece. This is like really, really kind of ugly, but this is perfect for this time of the year. So it's this holiday red and green and gold floral, and it's just this little blazer jacket. I'm telling you, this is perfect for this time of the year. The brand is Nana Collections by Jonathan Tate. It says it's a 15/16, and there is the label. This is another vintage Eddie Bauer, or not, it might not even be vintage, but it's just another Eddie Bauer. This is a size XXL, so great size. This dark red knit cardigan, and this was a fun find. My gosh, this was exciting. This does have flaws, but this is an LAMB fall 2007, size large. And if you know what LAMB is, that would be lamb, and that is Gwen Stefani's line. So it's just this basic like full zip hoodie, and then on the back it's got lamb, and it's got a hole up there. It's got some flaws. It says lamb going down this way. When I looked up comps on these, they were going, I think, for anywhere from like $50 to $90. This is a vintage Coldwater Creek, size small. Maybe not vintage, it's holiday 2008, but it's older at least. Perfect red button up. Again, another perfect like Christmas holiday item. This is also like a Y2K, long sleeve. This is a Jones New York Sport Petite, size medium. Again, I'll probably list it as a regular medium. High neck, turtleneck, little sheer lace, long sleeve, perfect little top. This is a vintage King's Road shop for Sears. The men's store, made in Korea, permapress, 100% polyester. This is probably 60s or 70s. It is just this brown paisley, long sleeve with a very pointed collar. This is really cool. So this is what I now realize, it's a curtain. And I thought it was maybe like a sheet for a crib or something, but you could obviously use this still as like a backdrop or something. It's a vintage Space Jam. I know, Space Jam 1996 curtain. So obviously it's for like a kid's bedroom or something, but it's the perfect backdrop or something, you know, you could use that for a couple different things. Last but not least, I found a pair of And Other Stories, pair of jeans, size 31/28. So they are just like these wide leg obviously wide leg jeans. And these could also be like new without tags also, since it's got the thing cut there. That is both hauls from Saturday and Sunday of last week. This is gonna be a very long video, so I apologize. Hopefully I edited it down to what I could so that it is not as crazy long, but it's still going to be long. But let me know down below what your favorite item was. I personally think that the second day haul was better than the first day haul, but let me know. Let me know what you thought and which haul you enjoyed. If you like this video, obviously give it a like and subscribe to my channel. But anyway, thank you for watching, and I hope to see you in the next one. Bye!